And guys, it's a good weekend. It's been fun. Earlier, we hosted the Canelo Con weigh-ins. But, you know, what does Golden Boy do? Hey, let's give the fans some free fights right now. Good vibe out here.
And you know what? We almost risked a rainout. There's a couple drops that came out. And Mother Nature did not get the production call sheet, obviously.
And, Doug, we're seeing the next generation of guys. Earlier, we saw Joette Gonzalez with the win. Golden Boy has a good young group. And our main event tonight, though, is a couple of their older fighters. Marvin Quintero is going to take on Peter Petrov. That'll be a good main event.
Yeah, Marvin Quintero is a former lightweight title challenger. He dropped a split decision to Miguel Vasquez a few years ago. Didn't give up on his dream. He was out for a while. He's coming to the ring right now, as a matter of fact.
There he is from Tijuana.
That's Horacio Garcia.
Oh, this is Horacio. I'm sorry, Horacio Garcia. We'll see Quintero in our main event. But Quintero, he stayed in the game, had a really good win against Jeffrey Fontanes, I believe.
Yes, he did. Knocked him out in Cancun.
And it was a surprise victory. He was sort of viewed as a guy kind of on the downslide. Beat a young up-and-comer to let everyone know, hey, I can still fight. I'm still a force in this division.
And this right here is Horacio Garcia, the guy that looked like Canelo. It's not him. It's his brother. As Horacio Garcia, managed by Canelo Alvarez. And the entire, you know, when one Canelo shows up, they all show up. I mean, when Alvarez shows up, they all show up.
Chepo Reynoso, the father figure, as far as boxing is concerned, Canelo Alvarez and Horacio Garcia is a part of all of Canelo's camps. We saw him last November here in Las Vegas, the night before Miguel Cotto, Canelo Alvarez, and he was very impressive. Only one loss, and that's to a former Japanese bantamweight champ who was one of the best of the past 10 years.
Hozumi Hasegawa.
Yeah, we'll get to Joe Martinez, our ring announcer for tonight, in about 2 minutes. But first, we got to take our selfies off. So if you are on your phone, you want to send us a tweet, Durant Sports, Steve UCN Live, and Dougie Fisher. Read your tweets all night long. I'll use the hashtag ringtvlive.com. Also have hot young fighter Joseph Diaz Jr. as a member of our crew. He's going to be jumping in with us. You'll hear from him. But one thing that we've noticed about what we've done here at Ring TV Live, the interaction from the fans. We do appreciate it, but we're starting to see these young fighters graduate to the next level, one of those being Joseph Diaz. It's just a good venue that Golden Boy has put together.
Well, Joseph Diaz, on the night of March 26th in Oakland, California, began the HBO broadcast and had a very nice victory over Jason Velez. I thought it was kind of appropriate given the fact that when you guys started this series back in March of 2015, the young man that headlined that particular night, Joseph Diaz.
Like our little kids are growing up.
Oh my God! But right in front of our eyes.
Right.
Where's
in
the
front
time
of them.
Go?
Next thing you know, they're gonna be hanging out with Steve at the Wild Card. But once again, do send us your tweets. Do appreciate it. And we also have on the card as another Spanish Slum plays on Cinco de Mayo weekend. Just when you think one's done, they're gonna have another one. This is what you call right here professional broadcasting. Pablo Cesar Cano. From Talepantla, Mexico, takes on Alan Sanchez, Guadalajara, Jalisco-based fighter from Fairfield. Now, that's going to be an entry one.
That's an excellent welterweight matchup. Horacio Garcia is next with his keys to this victory.
With Canelo, I learned how to prepare myself for a fight during camp. You learn a lot just by watching him. It's real motivation. The same things they were working with Canelo, they will work with me as well. I feel good, I feel well prepared, I'm ready for any rival that steps in the ring. I'm ready to win. I know it's gonna be a great fight and I have to put on a show. I'm ready to show everyone. I'm ready to display what I've been working on. This is a very important fight for my career. It's a great event put together by Golden Boy. To be part of this event in the new arena, I have to look sharp and I have to look strong. I will try my best to get the victory, hopefully by a knockout. That's always better than a decision.
There you hear a tattoo saying Feliz cumpleaños to... So Reynoso, is that really his birthday? Because there's been a lot of bad birthdays here. I don't think that's true. Joe Martinez.
Chiva Plaza de Las Vegas, Nevada. Damas y caballeros, muy buenas noches y bienvenidos a la noche de boxeo tremenda. Presentada por Oscar de la Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions y patrocinado por Cerveza Tecate Born Bold. Casa Mexico Tequila, it's in the taste. Hands of Stone, the true story of Roberto Duran, starring Edgar Ramirez, Robert De Niro, and Usher Raymond in theaters this August. Este pelea está pactado por 10 asaltos por el título vacante NBAF Peso Super Gallo. And here we go, fight fans. 10 rounds of boxing for the vacant NABF Super Bantamweight Championship. Presentado primero en la esquina azul, con los pantaloncillos rojos con plateado y un peso de 122 libras y medias. Su récord excelente con 15 victorias, 5 derrotas y 6 ganadas por nocaut de Oxnard, California, presentando Eric Ruiz. Y su frente en la esquina rojo, con pantaloncillos negro con verde y un peso de 121 libras y 3 cuartos. Su récord excelente con 30 victorias, 1 derrota, 21 ganadas por nocaut desde Guadalajara, Jalisco, México, presentando Horacio Violento García. Y el referee encargado del ring, Russell Mora.
Okay, trunks here are good. Trunks here are good. Anything below that line's a foul. Gentlemen, we went over the rules in the dressing room. Acuérdense, quiero una pelea limpia. Dios los bendiga. Toquen guantes.
Get ready for 10 rounds of action. Horacio, el violento, the violent one, Garcia. Is Eric Ruiz, and let's see the tail of the tail tape, Doug.
Yeah, Ruiz is 1 year younger at age 24. They have equal height at 5'6", and Ruiz has 2 inches in wingspan.
Horacio Garcia in the black trunks with the green trim. He's 30-1 in his career, 21 KOs, started his pro career in 2008. 25 years old out of Guadalajara, Mexico. His only loss coming to Hozumi Hasegawa in Japan last year, May 9th, and outwent 10 rounds. Came back and he beat Bule Hidalgo in the second round.
He was very impressive. If you've never seen Garcia fight, you're going to enjoy him. He lives up to that nickname. He's very aggressive, and when he has a guy hurt, he has that killer instinct. He goes for the finish. But against Eric Ruiz, he's in there with a very well-schooled young professional.
Eric Ruiz, 15-5, a veteran in Southern California stables. Only 24 years old, but he has those, everybody knows of him. He fought all over Southern California. Living and training in Oxnard, married, a couple kids. Last fight, he lost to Alexis Santiago. Before that, he upset Roy Tapia the same night that Raul Hidalgo, but the following day after Hidalgo was beat up by Horacio Garcia. Eric Ruiz in the red trunks. Spoke to him briefly, said the last thing he wants to do is go and become that journeyman guy. He's a tough opponent, trained by Robert Garcia.
Yeah, he's too young and too good to be considered a journeyman. I would consider him sort of a young gatekeeper right now. He's a crafty and versatile boxer, and he knows when to box and he knows when to fight. That's what impressed me against Roy Tapia. He knew how to outbox and neutralize Tapia's aggressiveness. And over the second half of the fight, he took advantage of Tapia's fatigue and stepped up his own aggression.
Less than a minute to go in the opening round, scheduled for 10. Outside in Las Vegas on the eve of Canelo and Khan.
It's a brisk first round. Both guys have landed some hard power shots.
Good jab from Ruiz in the red trunks. Good hook. Garcia in that Canelo camp in northern San Diego County. Good right landed by Garcia. Early hook on, landed by Ruiz.
Beto, I think it's very evident in round number one, both guys landing leather, as Doug stated, but you could just feel the punches of Garcia. There's a certain heaviness to his shots that Ruiz simply doesn't have.
Final seconds of the opening round. It's scheduled for 10 at the Toshiba Plaza, in front of the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas. Golden Boy matchmaker Roberto Diaz on the strategy for this fight.
I'm sure with Horacio, he's learning a lot watching Canelo, watching somebody who's already at the elite level working so hard. That has to inspire a young fighter to say, wow, if he, that's why he has what he has. I want to obtain that. I have to work hard too. You know, you could see the work physically, but you could also see he's not just a let me go out and throw punches. He's a very technically sound fighter. I'm curious to see more of him and see how he gets through Eric Ruiz, because Eric, we know, is a crafty fighter. We know what he can do. He's always in great condition. You know, Eric doesn't throw a lot of punches. He's very conservative in his punches, but he lands very well. He's always in there calm, cool, and he's probably coming in to try to spoil another fighter like he did last year.
Roberto Diaz, the matchmaker for Golden Boy. A busy weekend as 14 fights are being put on by Golden Boy Promotions on Canelo Con weekend. Jimmy D, three-piece boxing. Appreciate you taking that snapshot of us. Yes, we are the Three Amigos, but we took off the ties for this fight. Rolling up the sleeves, Sarah Duran at UC Davis watching this one on Ring TV Live. Appreciate that. Get back to studying. Also, UC Davis has a good club boxing team up there. The second round is brought to you by RingTV.com. Visit RingTV.com for more great boxing content throughout the week.
Steve, so far in this fight, it looks like the weapon of choice for Garcia is that straight right, and the weapon of choice for Ruiz is his jab and the hook off the jab.
Yeah, both guys have a very solid skill set. I'll say one thing, though. Just looking at Ruiz, 20 fights, just 6 stoppages. Clear to me, he's going to have to be a little bit slicker and a little bit quicker off the trigger, like that, and doing a really nice job. That was a great job of counter-punching and timing,
yes.
Garcia.
Worked a couple of Ruiz-ish fights, and one thing I've noticed, going back and looking at some film of it and just in the notes that I put down afterwards, like he stands in the middle.
Yeah.
He's not a guy that moves around a lot. He will trade with you.
I like to say about guys like him, you don't need a GPS unit to find him. He's going to be in the pocket most of the night.
Well, he's a good counter puncher, so he wants you to come to him. He doesn't want to run away from you. But he wants you to come to him. But and you know, present opportunities for him to counterpunch.
But in this particular situation, he's fighting a very slick guy for Ruiz. He's got very quick hands. And again, he flashes that right hand right over the top with the low left hand coming off the jab from Garcia.
Garcia in the black trunks with the green trim. Trained by Chepo Reynoso. Canelo's trainer.
I think this has been a very good round for Ruiz. I think he's simply beating Garcia to the punch. He's not punching as hard, but I think he's landing much more accurately. And he's surprising Garcia with punches he may not necessarily be seeing.
I think Garcia is boxing out of character right now, jabbing and moving around Ruiz. And maybe Ruiz has gotten to his head a little bit by just, you know, kind of staking out the middle of the ring. But I want to see some pressure from Garcia. And I want to see some body shots and more combinations.
You know, when you get hit with shots you don't see coming and they land cleanly, that will give you pause. That will give you a moment to think, like, do you necessarily want to be so reckless in your attack? I'll tell you one thing about Ruiz, he's got very good eyes. And that's part of being a good counterpuncher, is having that really good radar and anticipating what shots come your way.
Good 1-2 landed by the Guadalajara fighter, Horacio Garcia. Body shot from Garcia. Ruiz right there. Good hunt from Ruiz in the red trunks. Good right from Ruiz. A solid round for Eric Ruiz from Oxnard, California. Final seconds of the second. It's scheduled for 10 in Las Vegas.
This is the Black Eagle. This is a champion. Just isn't right. This is all he needs. Flavor that can't be tamed. Tecate Light, born bold.
Canelo Alvarez is boxing's number one star. Amir Khan has boxing's fastest hands. Saturday, May 7th.
Hard right hand by Canelo.
Unparalleled power.
Time, first round for Khan.
Unsurpassed speed.
This is my time. Let's do this.
Canelo versus Khan, Saturday, May 7th.
Eric Ruiz in the red. Horacio Garcia in the black and green. And the third round is brought to you by The Ring Magazine. The Ring Magazine, the Bible of boxing since 1922. Subscribe today. Stephen Duran, Doug Fisher, and Steve Kim here at ringside. Make sure you send us your tweets using the hashtag RingTVLive. Good jab from each fighter. Right from Garcia. Another right from Garcia. Double the jab, uppercut. Good start to the third round from the Guadalajara fighter, Garcia.
I think aggression is a good thing with Garcia. I don't think he should think too much in there. He certainly should not try to second guess himself. If he eats a counterpunch, you know what? Punch when the other guy punches.
But Doug, I do get the sense that Ruiz is allowing Garcia to do certain things offensively to set stuff up down the line. He's got a very good clear path. Like I said, he's got very good eyes. He sees everything coming, and again, you see him coming right up the middle, and he's able to punch in between some of the attacks of Garcia.
This is heating up into a really good fight because both guys are landing flush power shots.
And you see Chepo Reynoso, the trainer for Garcia, patriarch of the Reynoso family. You watch the 24/7. He's the butcher also. Now he's all into gardening. But right now he's got to figure out a way to get his fighter a win because Garcia and Ruiz are mixed in good. Ruiz trained by Robert Garcia. Ruiz blocking shots, landing one of his own. At the Toshiba Plaza outside the brand new T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas. The first ever event was a Guns N' Roses concert May 8th. Tomorrow night, it'll be the first ever sporting event inside the T-Mobile Arena. Go to CaneloCon.com and buy that fight. Also download the Tecate Bold Punch app. Standing right in the middle of the ring. Not going to go anywhere, Derek Ruiz.
It's not an easy round to score. These guys are going tit for tat.
Ruiz turned pro in 2011. Also lost to Daniel Roman September 2015. Lost to Tino Avila May of 2015. Step up in competition in both of those.
Beto, he also has a loss to Jesse Magdalena, who's in line for a 122-pound title shot. I'll say one thing about Ruiz at 15-5. This is a young man. He's probably better than his overall record indicates.
Fourth round of action about to get going, and this one is brought to you by Yip TV. Watch live TV from around the globe, including live Golden Boy fights. Sign up today at YipTV.com. And this fight is being broadcast all over the world, also in Canada. Appreciate it, our neighbors of the north. And you're going to get to see a Canadian, David Lemieux, on the co-feature of Canelo Khan as he takes on Jersey boy Glenn Tapia.
It's a can't-miss action fight. This is an action fight right now. Although it's controlled aggression from both guys.
Doug, I don't know who you gave round three to. I edged it to Garcia based on the early margin that he had in the first 20 seconds of that round. But I have a 29-28 Garcia. I think we better buckle in here and really hunker down. I think it's going to be a long, hard, tough fight.
And if we're going to score these rounds, we got to pay really close attention because they are close.
No. You guys are talking more. Doug, you showed up on Wednesday. You need to talk a little bit more this evening. We were here Monday night. All the grand arrivals, the press conferences, everything behind the scenes feature. Make sure you go to the Tecate Bowl Punch app and you'll see all of that. Also, the live streams for anything you need. Good right landed by Garcia. Body shot upstairs, Garcia.
Ruiz has got to come up with a counterpunch for that short right cross from Garcia. Whenever Garcia tries to go to his body with the left hand, Ruiz lands his left hook to the head. He's got certain punches for certain power shots in Garcia's arsenal, but I don't think he's come up with an answer offensively or defensively for that short right cross.
It's scheduled for 10. If you're joining us right now, this is exactly how the fight started. Nothing's changed.
Don't do that.
What was Mora warning Luis
for? Well, I think he was holding his head down just a little bit.
Okay. Just a bit. Just enough.
Yeah, I didn't see anything egregious, but maybe I missed it.
These guys need much to separate them, though. Take care of it themselves.
Yeah, I mean, there's no like holding. Not a lot. It hasn't been clinches and a lot of holding or grappling or mauling or any of that. These guys are very comfortable at mid-range.
Punch for punch. Land one, I land one. Ruiz very comfortable with being the counterpuncher. Ruiz in the red trunks. Garcia with a black and green. She looks ripped. It's getting closer to where we're sitting.
He's in terrific condition.
Runs with Canelo in the mornings. Couple of left hooks landed by Ruiz. Ruiz really liking that left hook.
I think that's his best punch. And it's not that it's a hard punch, it's just very well timed.
Final second of the fourth, it's scheduled for 10.
Estás dejando toda la iniciativa y lo estás haciendo bravo al cabrón. ¿Por qué? Porque no tiras. Porque estás acobardado, estás amarrado, no veniste a pelear. No veniste a pelear, cabrón. Tanto pinche tiempo, 2 meses allá para nada.
Fifth round of action, one of the cool features here on RingTVLive.com, besides having Steve and Doug and their expertise and being able to quote every single fight from 1982 and on. And if you want to go deep, that's why he's the editor of RingTV.com. RingTV.com is the editor, is Doug Fisher. So many .coms I got to throw around right now. Is the 2012 Olympian joining us, Joseph Diaz Jr. JoJo coming off an impressive win over Jason Velez. We'll be roaming around today, giving us a different insight, interviews also. And JoJo, what do you see in this fight so far?
You know what, I think this is a very tough fight. I feel like it's all tied up right now, 2-2. I have it all evened up right now. I mean, I feel like Ruiz is taking full advantage of Garcia's flaw. And that flaw is not bringing his punches back together where they came from. I feel like whenever he's throwing a shot, he's putting his punches down, and Eric Ruiz is taking full advantage and landing some counter shots, and he's landing effective counter shots. But I feel like Garcia is now taking a little bit of control in this round. He's being more aggressive. I think he sees that he has Ruiz a little more tired. So it's a very close fight, very entertaining fight, and it could go either way right now.
Undefeated Joseph Diaz Jr., 2012 Olympian from South El Monte, one of the hot ones coming up. He'll be fighting, according to Steve Kim's news and notes, later in July.
Well, Beto, I got that straight from the horse's mouth. You were there when I talked to him. Beto, I agree with Joseph Diaz. I think it's 2-2. And Robert Garcia, the trainer of Ruiz, is to our left, and we can hear him consistently exhorting Ruiz to do just a little bit more. Because remember, when you play the counter-punching role the way he is, your margin for error is a little bit closed off, and he's not quite the heavy-handed guy that Garcia is. I think he wants just a little bit more activity.
I think JoJo called it. He said that Ruiz is starting to tire right now, and Garcia is sensing it, and he's coming on. And when Garcia is letting his hands go and coming forward, he is fighting to his style and his ring mentality.
And Ruiz, with the mouth open in this round for the first time in the fight, he ended up in the corner, able to work himself out of there. Garcia bringing it on with a little bit more pressure. Garcia in the green. Ruiz giving his hands down a little bit more than normal.
He's slowed the momentum a little bit here in the final half minute of this round that Garcia had. He's landed some nice 1-2 combinations right down the pike. But the first 2 minutes of this round was all Garcia.
Horacio Garcia, Eric Ruiz. 10 seconds to go in the fifth round, scheduled for 10. A good one, our opening bout here on Ring TV Live from Las Vegas.
Canelo Alvarez is boxing's number one star. Amir Khan has boxing's fastest hands. Saturday, May 7th.
Hard right hand by Canelo.
Unparalleled power. Unsurpassed speed.
This is my time. Let's do this.
Canelo versus Khan, Saturday, May 7th.
Canelo Khan tomorrow night. Go to CaneloCon.com and buy it for your mobile device or your computer if you're a cord cutter.
You're going to be able to hear the tones of Steve Kim and Doug Fisher. You're ready to go. That's where we're at right now, the sixth round. This one is brought to you by the new Pixie at Pixie. Live curiously. You see fans outside standing remotely. Free fight. Golden Boy Promotions bringing free fights to the fans immediately after the weigh-in. Stuck around, and here you're watching our first bout. Horacio Garcia in the green, Eric Ruiz in the red. And Steve, after five, what do you got?
I have it 48-47, Garcia. I thought he took the fifth with his early activity. I think every round has been close. In fact, they've swapped rounds throughout the first half of the fight.
I see it exactly the same way you see it, Steve. And I bet you Joseph JoJo Diaz sees it exactly as we do.
He's such a smart young man.
That's a sharp boxing mind.
He really is.
Sharp? Yeah, we're in Vegas. You can use that word. A little sharps out here. A good one, Eric Ruiz. And after this one's going to be Pablo Cesar Cano and Alan Sanchez in our main event, Marvin Quintero, Peter Petrov.
A nice hook from Garcia. We're not seeing as many body punches as we're used to seeing from Garcia because of the counter-punching skill of Ruiz.
You know, I think early on in this round, we're starting to see some of the strength and power, just as Ruiz lands a very good counter left hook, starting to impose itself just a little bit on Ruiz.
And Garcia, he's a big, strong junior featherweight. To me, he has a featherweight's frame, the bone structure of a full-bodied 126-pounder.
We're west of the Las Vegas Strip between New York, New York, and the Monte Carlo. That's where we're at right now outside the T-Mobile Arena. First sporting event on the grounds. Over 2 acres of grounds. You can go to different restaurants, different bars. Just a cool setup. So there's probably people walking by going to have dinner like, oh, let me catch this fight. Yep, right. Here you go. Groundbreaking in the area was May 1st of 2014. Over $375 million cost of this project. 650,000 square footage is the T-Mobile Arena. We're outside in the plaza. Tomorrow night, Canelo Khan. Right now, Garcia Ruiz. You hear Robert Garcia, not just one, yeah. but 0-2.
He wants a little bit more work. He's getting outworked this round, and the momentum is clearly swinging right now to Garcia's side.
Especially the last couple rounds.
Yeah. There's a fine line between counterpunching and just catching. Counterpunching means you're actually shooting back. Right now, he's doing much more catching than actual counterpunching.
Horacio Garcia, 30-1, 21 KOs in the black. Final seconds of the round. It's scheduled for 10. A good tough one between Garcia and Ruiz in Las Vegas on Ring TV Live.
Encima tirándole al cuerpo, a los brazos, a donde le pegues al cabrón, ¿ok? Pero métele presión, no quiero ni un pinche segundo de reposo. Tú encima, sa. Es lo que hace tirada. Tú ya lo tienes, ¿ok? ¿Cómo se siente? ¿Bien? Vamos a sacar la pelea, ¿eh? Es muy importante esa pelea. Está buena, muchacho, pero no es mejor que tú. Tú eres mejor que él, así que nomás. Tú eres mucho más fuerte, pues lo muestro, muñeco. Metiéndole presión y presión y presión y presión.
About 62 degrees outside. I'm right here. This is where we're sitting. We're watching Eric Ruiz and Horacio Garcia. The seventh round is brought to you by Philmon.com. Cool afternoon. Good, about to be evening in Las Vegas. These two in the ring are heating it up. Good exchange. Garcia and Ruiz. This is how the fight started. Instead in the middle, exchanging. Keep on going. Last couple rounds, the Guadalajara fighter Ruiz has been bringing it on. I mean, Garcia has been bringing it on. Ruiz from Oxnard in the red trunks, absorbing it.
We're seeing a higher volume from Garcia. We're seeing him put more punches together and also mix up body punches, like that beautiful left hook to the body with his head shots. And I expected that because Don Chepo Reynoso was very animated between rounds. And I'm sure you recognize the guy who was holding the petroleum jelly.
Chololo Larios.
Oscar Larios, former junior featherweight champion.
You're not supposed to cut off your partners, but I'm cutting you off.
Cut me off.
Dougie just dropped a Don Chepo, and then Steve rolled with a Chololo.
Chololo.
That
was his moniker, and I still remember from
memorable
battle.
It might be his moniker, but not many dudes can say Chololo the way you did right there.
You know, that's just that East LA education that
Qué
I have.
Qué bonito amor, me gusta Esteban. Yeah.
Montebello High School, the Harvard of East LA.
The Oilers, baby. Or you could have gone to Cantwell like Carla in the Golden Boy office. Or you can be Indio like Carlita or Jessica. Hello to all the girls in the Golden Boy office watching us right now on RingTVLive.com. Appreciate it. Without your support this weekend, does not happen.
Continue They've been doing
work.
A great job all week.
Everybody on the staff, remember, we got one more. We're going to put that mano arriba like Omar says, la cintura suelta. Here we go, seventh round. Ruiz and Garcia. It's a good scrap. This is what Eric Ruiz is, huh? That guy who gives you the rounds. He's tough, but he nails, man.
You know why he'll always find work, though, Angel?
I admire this kid.
Be on TV. Win, lose, or draw, he gives you good stuff.
Yeah, it's entertaining. Yeah. He just doesn't do enough to win enough rounds to win pivotal fights. Did you see him? He himself is content to make you miss and make you miss and make you pay a little bit. When I can hear Robert Garcia saying,
not enough.
Yeah, you can hear Robert Garcia saying, come on, make him pay more. Yeah, come on, keep going.
Normally we would give somebody the headset so we can hear him, but no, Robert, you can hear him through our headset.
He has a bloody nose.
Yeah. Ruiz is landing. Look at the face of
right hand.
Yeah, right hand rocked him.
Ruiz hurts him. In the corner is Garcia. Ruiz Pouncey, 10 seconds to go in the seventh round. A big one for Eric Ruiz from Oxnard, as they call it up there, Boxnard, as he's looking good here in the seventh. And that'll do it. Ruiz fired up.
What a momentum shift.
Garcia started that round so strong and so animated, working the body and the head for the first minute. And then for the second minute, Ruiz made him miss. And then really for the last 30 seconds, Ruiz put it on him, but I noticed the face of Garcia, not just blood from the nose, but there's cuts around the eyes.
Doug, you know what Ruiz is? He's sneaky. He just sneakily crafty. Beats you up, and he's very crafty, and he's been very sharp, and this has been a huge momentum shift. Doug, three rounds to go. I have it 67-66 Garcia, who right now, he's reeling.
This is Eric Ruiz working Horacio Garcia in Garcia's own corner.
Before that moment, though, it was a straight right that buckled the legs of Garcia. And before Garcia was buckled, the face started to come apart.
Eighth round. This one is brought to you by RingTV.com. Visit RingTV.com for more great boxing content throughout the week. Biggest round for Eric Ruiz was in that seventh, and that blood and the cut was caused by a punch, being told.
Beto, the hunter is now the prey. Eric Ruiz is just coming forward. He's got all the momentum in the world. You look at the facial expression of Garcia. He looks like a completely different guy. He is now, I don't want to say in full-blown survival mode, but he is now the guy on the back foot.
He's leery. You can see it in his body language. The wind has been taken from his sails.
Eric Ruiz has been in those tough scraps over the years. You mentioned it, that Jesse Magdaleno fight in Las Vegas. He went the distance. Tito Avila at the Palasco was a tough one. Daniel Roman was a tough one. Roy Tapia, which he won, was a tough one. And Alexis Santiago was a tough one. And Horacio Garcia, most of his career, the beginning parts of it, was padded.
Yeah, and Beto, about 10 seconds ago, another overhand right found its home, and it has Garcia backing up.
Good stiff jab. Roberto Diaz, the matchmaker for Golden Boy, watching intently.
If you remember this past November, Ruiz against Roy Tapia, Ruiz finished that fight very strong.
He
came on in the second half. He's doing the same thing in this fight.
That was the fight where Roy Tapia didn't throw enough late in the rounds. And it Tapia his first loss.
Well, Tapia ran out of steam, and it should be noted, when you miss a punch, it takes a lot of energy from you. And Ruiz does make you miss a lot.
Bobby Garcia telling him no tiene, he doesn't have any. Right, Coach Steve, that running out of gas possibly for Garcia, breathing heavy. Blood coming down to the mouth. With a Guadalajara fighter in the green.
Beto, I don't think it's just fatigue either. I think he's been hit hard, and a lot of these punches you don't see coming. This Ruiz is so crafty. He just kind of sneakily beats you up. And you just look at the expression on his body. Boy, he's really holding on the inside, and Ruiz doing a nice job of just rotating his shoulders, letting his hands go.
Eric Ruiz looks like a different fighter right now than he did 6 minutes ago.
Yeah, I agree. In round six, it looked like Ruiz was running out of gas, and Garcia was coming on. He had a very strong round, maybe the strongest of the fight. And then round seven, in the final minute, the roles are reversed.
Boy, I tell you, guys, you take a look at the face of Garcia. It is really bruised up, swollen, and red.
That right side of Garcia, and what has he been throwing all night is Ruiz, that left hook. Landing efficiently. Final seconds of the eighth round. A good one. Garcia Ruiz.
Golden Boy matchmaker Roberto Diaz. He is involved in this fight. And he always puts together good features, good opening TV bouts and co-features. And you're seeing some two-way action right here from round eight, which I'm sure you scored as I did. Most of the round looked like this. Ruiz in pursuit of Garcia. Here he is backing him into the blue corner and teeing off with both hands. Now we're seeing that activity that Robert Garcia has wanted from Ruiz all fight.
You know, Doug, Ruiz does not have classic heavy hands, but when you throw the punches with good snap, technique, and torque the way he's throwing them and consistently touching them, you see the effects on the face of Horacio Garcia. Doug, taking a look at the expression of Robert Diaz, he's probably thinking to himself, did I make too good of a fight tonight?
Getting ready for the ninth round. Thanks for watching. Joey Cuevas, the diehard Phoenix Suns fan in Indiana.
Oh.
Watching us, appreciate it. Send us your tweets at RingTV Live is the hashtag we're using. We're in the
ninth round, and this one is brought to you by The Ring Magazine. The Ring Magazine, the Bible of boxing since 1922. Subscribe today and order yourself some of those cool shirts. I ordered a green, white, and red one the other day. Those money will be going to Doug Fisher's pocket.
It doesn't work that way.
Joseph Diaz Jr. watching ringside. What do you think of the way that Ruiz has come on, JoJo?
Man, this fight's incredible. It's a very exciting fight. I have it all tied up right now, four rounds apiece. This fight's, I mean, very exciting for the fight fans, but I feel like Eric Ruiz is taking full control right now. It seemed like the last two rounds he had Garcia backing up, and Garcia couldn't, you know, sit down on the shots like how he was earlier. Right now it seems like Garcia's, you know, sitting down and landing effective blows, but it feels like Eric Ruiz is getting the best exchanges right now. And I just see that Garcia is getting a little tired and getting a little frustrated, and Eric Ruiz is, you know, winning this round as of right now.
Joseph Diaz Jr., 2012 Olympian, representing the United States in London. Had Kevin Durant at his games. You're big time. Kobe came to watch him. Right now he's watching Ruiz and Garcia.
You know, this is the period of time, Doug. I think Ruiz has to come out of his shell and be something that he's not, and that is the initiator. I think he has softened up Garcia to the point. He is now right on the cusp of pulling this upset. He's right there. He's got to be able to, or be willing to, push this guy off the cliff.
Yeah, he doesn't want to take his foot off the gas pedal and give Garcia any sign of hope. Doesn't want to give him any kind of confidence and let Garcia work his way back into the fight. Because you know Garcia, he's got heart.
You know, and speaking of Garcia, Robert Garcia, I see him right now. He is like a jockey just going to the whip. He is really involved in this fight. We've been able to hear him throughout the night to our left side.
And he has to. Yeah. He's got to be vocal between rounds and even during the rounds, because I don't think it's his fighter's
temperament.
To be the aggressor. But that's exactly what he needs to be if he wants to win this fight.
And also, Robert Garcia lives in Riverside now. That's where the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy is at. Eric Ruiz lives in Oxnard. So Garcia is his trainer for the fight, but during the actual week, they communicate in different ways. They're not doing the hands-on feature. Maybe that might have been part of the reason why Ruiz started off slow. Once he gets into the mix with his trainer.
This has been a very close round. Garcia's had a pretty good segment here, letting his hands go. Ruiz has to be very careful not to let Garcia steal this round.
Eric Ruiz, the nurses in Harbor City, Sandra Castro's in the crew, watching him right now. He's fighting Horacio Garcia. Final seconds at the Toshiba Plaza outside the brand new T-Mobile Arena on the eve of Canelo and Khan. A good one, a good scrap in Las Vegas. The 10th and final round, a tough one between Horacio Garcia in the black trunks, Eric Ruiz in the red. And this round is brought to you by Yip TV. Watch live TV from around the globe, including live Golden Boy fights on YipTV.com. And guys, going into the 10th, how do you have it scored, Steve?
I gave that last round, based on the last 10 seconds, to Eric Ruiz in the ninth. I thought he re-stole the round. I am up by one with 3 minutes to go.
And I scored round nine just by a hair for Garcia. So I have Garcia by 1 point.
Doug, I'd say you need glasses, but you already have them on.
You know, and that's
respectfully, of course.
He has it just for looks, like Westbrook. He has LASIK. But that's the way that you guys have it scored different ways. I can see exactly how a fight fan out here or a judge can have it either way. And this 10th round is up for grabs. Horacio Garcia coming out a little bit more aggressive than he did the last couple ones. He's 30-1. Ruiz, 15-5.
Good right hand by Ruiz.
That has been the story.
Another left hook by Ruiz.
That sneaky punch, either with the right hand over the top or the left hook. And I got to tell you, you mentioned this a couple of rounds ago, Beto. I don't think Garcia, when he looks in the mirror tonight, is going to recognize himself.
He needs to put on those Versace glasses or the Carrera. There's a song, El Hombre de Lente Carrera, the black sunglasses. He's going to need that.
He's not feeling like himself right now. He's usually the punisher.
No, he is.
He's not used to receiving this much punishment.
You know, and he's getting his hands moving, but most of those are arm punches. And Ruiz is able to weave in between them. And I think he's landing the harder, sharper shots here in the 10th round.
Yeah, I agree, Steve. And he's evading most of Garcia's power shots. He's catching him with his gloves. Or he's ducking under him, slipping him.
A minute to go in the fight. Ruiz hurt Garcia in the seventh. Could that be enough to sway the opinion of some judges? Or did Garcia do enough early on in the rounds? 50 seconds to go. Who's going to steal this last round? Two dog-tired guys right now. You're asking
Good left hook by Ruiz.
Bread and butter all night. Look at that, another left hook from Ruiz.
Beto, I agree, they're both tired. They're certainly put in 29 and a half hard minutes. But Ruiz is the one that still has a little bit of snap and torque to his punches.
I agree. I think he's had a very good 10th and final round.
Right hand landed by Garcia. Managed by Canelo. They're gonna do enough to win this fight. Final seconds has been a good scrap between Garcia and Ruiz in Las Vegas. They go the distance. We'll be back with the final decision as Horacio Garcia, Aaron Ruiz go the distance on Ring TV Live. Outside the Toshiba Plaza, right next to New York. New York is where we're at tonight for Ring TV Live. Golden Boy Promotions bringing free fights to the fans. You see Robert Garcia and his fighter, Eric Ruiz. He went the distance with Horacio Garcia. And we're going to be going to the decision in a few moments.
And we're looking at some action from the fight. This is Eric Ruiz taking it to Horacio Garcia. Trying to land his left hook. Most of those left hooks landed. There's a nice right cross to the temple from Ruiz. There's a nice lead right from Ruiz. There's a right uppercut from Ruiz. He gets clipped by a big left hook from Garcia, who was game throughout. but really struggled in the late rounds.
Steve. Doug, I thought in round six that Garcia had the physical control. Round seven, that one right big shot changed the momentum of this fight.
And now, fine fans, after 10 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. La Wens Lisa Giampa noto 98-92. Giampa has it 98-92. Ruiz. Ricardo Ocasio, 97-93. Garcia. Y el Wes Clements anotó 95-95, 95-95. Una decisión dividida, empate. We have a split draw.
Wow.
Well, I agree with the ultimate decision. I had it five rounds apiece, a draw 95-95.
I don't see how
Judge Giampa had it that one-sided for Ruiz, 98-92. I don't see how the second judge had it 97-93 for Garcia. I don't think anybody dominated that much. It was like a 6-4 fight, you know what I mean? Just a fight that it's either a draw or the winner wins by like 2 points.
And Doug, I agree personally. I had it 96-94 Ruiz.
It was a draw. Horacio Garcia, Eric Ruiz. A good scrap ends up in a draw. We'll be back with more on Ring TV Live.